In the present video session, I'll be explaining the concept of PPP, that is point-to-point protocol, PPP frame format, and transition phases with respect to point-to-point protocol. So the most common protocol for point-to-point access is point-to-point protocol or PPP. So we can use HTLC protocol with respect to point-to-point as well as multi-point link. Today, millions of internet users who wants to connect their home computer to the server of an internet service provider uses PPP, that is point-to-point protocol. So the type of the modem used may be traditional one. So this modem can be connected to the internet. So we need to connect this modem to the internet using a telephone line. But we need to control as well as manage transfer of data. For that purpose, we are using the protocol called as PPP, and this protocol we can use in the data link layer. PPP provides several services, like it defines the frame format which is to be exchanged between two devices. PPP also defines how two devices can negotiate the establishment of the link and how the data can be exchanged between two devices. It also defines how the network layer data are encapsulated in the data link layer as frame. So that means the packet can be encapsulated into frame. PPP defines how two devices can authenticate with each other. So PPP provides multiple network layer service supporting a variety of network layer protocols. So PPP also provides connections over multiple links. PPP provides network address configuration. This is particularly useful when a home user needs a temporary network address to connect to the internet. PPP frame format. PPP uses character-oriented or byte-oriented frame. It uses character-oriented or else byte-oriented frame. The PPP frame format consisting of following fields like flag field, address field, and control field, which is of 1 byte in size, followed by the protocol field, which may be around 1 or 2 bytes, payload field, which is obviously variable in size, frame check sequence, FCS, which may be around 2 or 4 bytes, followed by the flag field, which is once again 1 byte. So now we'll take the individual field descriptions in detail. The first field is flag field. In the case of PPP, the flag field is of 1 byte with the bit pattern 0 followed by 6 ones and 0. So it's the same bit pattern we used in the case of HTLC protocol. But HTLC is a bit-oriented protocol, but PPP is a byte-oriented protocol. So the next field is address field. So this address field is of 1 byte, and the value of this address field is nothing but the broadcast address with all ones. So the next field is control field, again which is of 1 byte. The value of the control field will be equal to 11 followed by 6 zeros. But PPB does not provide flow as well as error control. It does not support flow as well as error control. Error control is there, but which is limited to the error detection. So therefore, during negotiation, both the parties can agree in order to discard this respective byte. Next field is protocol field. The size of the protocol field is of around 2 bytes long, but the two parties can agree in order to use only 1 byte. This protocol field defines what kind of data which is to be carried out, whether the actual data, that means the user data, or any other kind of information. So the next field is payload field, which carries the data in terms of bytes. So the maximum size of the payload field will be around 1500 bytes, but this can be changed during the negotiation. And suppose the flag field appears within the data field, in such instance we can go for byte stuffing concept. So the next field is FCS, that is frame check sequence, which is of around 2 to 4 byte in size for standard CRC. So PPP is a byte oriented protocol, but in some instance the flag may appear in the actual data section of the frame. So in such cases we need to use a special character which is called as escape character, and the size of this escape character, that is nothing but 1 byte with the value 0 1 1 1 1 1 and 0 1, which means that every time the flag like pattern appears in the data, so we need to stuff one extra byte in order to tell the receiver that the next byte is not a flag value. The diagram shows PPP transition phases. So transition diagram is nothing but an FSM itself. The initial state in the case of PPP is dead state, which means that the transition diagram starts from the dead phase. So here we are not consisting of any active carriers. When one of the two nodes starts the communication, so the connection goes to the established phase or established state, where two parties need to negotiate with each other. So after successful negotiation, we can say that the carriers can be detected or identified. So suppose the carriers are failed, carrier detection is failed, so at that instant, once again, the state is nothing but the dead state. So after established state, suppose those two parties need to authenticate with each other, it can go to the next state called as authenticate state. Suppose the authentication is not required, directly it can go to the next state, that is network state. So suppose the authentication is required, so and authentication is successful, it can go to the network state. Suppose the authentication is failed, we can terminate the actual connection. And suppose those two parties are not willing to go to the authenticate state, directly from the established state it can go to the network state. So here the actual network configuration can take place, and the next state is open state, where the actual data can be exchanged between those two parties. After completion of data transfer, once it is done, it can terminate the actual connection. But the system remains in the terminate state until all the carriers are dropped. So after all the carriers are dropped, once again this from the terminate state it goes to the initial state, that is nothing but the dead state. In the case of dead phase, there is no active carriers are present and the link is not being used. So the second one is established phase. When one of the nodes starts the communication, the connection goes to the established phase. So in the case of established phase, so both the parties can negotiate with each other. After successful negotiation, the system can go to the authentication phase if authentication is required, or else directly it can go to the networking phase. Authentication phase, so which is optional one. The two nodes may decide during the establishment phase either to go to the authentication phase or skip this authentication phase. After authentication phase, if the result is successful, the connection goes to the networking phase, else the connection goes to the termination phase. So next one is network phase. So in the case of network phase, negotiation for the network layer protocol takes place. PPP specifies two nodes need to establish a network layer agreement before the data at the network layer can be exchanged. So multiple protocols can be used at the network layer. If the node is running multiple protocols simultaneously at the network layer, receiver node must and should know which respective protocol it need to be used in order to receive the data. Open phase. The data transfer can take place in the open phase. When the connection reaches to open phase, the exchange of data packets can be started. And connection remains in this phase until one of the endpoint wants to terminate the connection. So the next one is terminate phase. In the terminate phase, the connection is terminated. After exchange of several packets between two parties, and one party need to agree for the termination of the connection, but the system remains in the terminate state until all the carriers are dropped. Once all the carriers are dropped, once again it go to the dead state where there is no active carriers are present. For any queries, please mail me at sadhana.b@canaraengineering.in. Thank you.